Welcome back to the Long Dark Science Experiments. Let's take a look at our status here. We're at about 40% condition. So we need to have a little snack here. Let's eat this. I wonder if we can eat that. Let's see what happens. What's the worst that could happen? See, we didn't even get food poisoning. Sort it by condition. Drink that. So we're just about full. We need a drink. We can put quite a bit of this water into the fridge, save it for later. Leave this with a liter and a half. We can easily come back for that. We're full, so we don't need to carry all this stuff. Okay then, we're going to need to make some more of that, so we'll need some water. Let's see, where's the water? That should be enough. We'll make the lowest condition of tea. We'll take that one. So that'll make 5 cups. That should be enough. And we're gonna need fuel. Yes, indeed. We have none here. Let's take the charcoal. We have water here. Oh, we have a lot of water here. This goes out onto that porch. This goes out onto the front porch. Let's go take a look at what's outside. What time is it? Oh, it's early morning, mid morning. We have for weapons. No weapons. Where is the rifle? We leave it downstairs? Probably did, hey? Yes, here it is. We'll need that. We're gonna need that. Might as well bring that full load of tools, except for the hacksaw. The hacksaw can be repaired, so that's why it's a good idea to use it. Whereas with your knife and your hatchet, you have to have whetstone. Creep up over this. I see crows heading off that way. See any deer. Looks like there's something out there. That's the direction to the cave, and there's the radio tower up there.
Use this.
Insulated boots. I'll bring all that. Now let's see what our status is.
Too much stuff to carry.
Yeah, you got a lot of stuff right now. Well, there's nothing out here, so let's go back in the house, get rid of this extra stuff. I don't know if we can wear the wear that. No. So it's a trade-off between the rabbit skin hat and that thing. This is 1.95. Oh, this is much less. Okay, we'll get rid of that as well. Okay, clothing. Okay, that's down to the essentials, what we're wearing. It's fairly warm out. We could leave this. This is really heavy. If we had another jacket to switch into, which we don't have handy. I like the ski jacket because it's really light. It's like a shell, just protects you from wetness. So what's our inventory now? 31, much more manageable. I think we have some guts. We could make some rabbit snares. There seems to be nothing around here. I thought there was a box that used to be here. Or here. And often there's a deer carcass in here too. But it's not here. Let's go up here and spy around. Can see quite a distance here without scaring the animals, so at least we hope we can see where they're at. I don't see anything moving. There's a wolf somewhere off to our right. Yep. So let's clean this old rifle here. Let's clean it. I didn't unload it first, but oh well. Improvement is 6%, and it is now 90%. Rifle clearance is 90%. What's the rifle at? 59. Let's clean it again and see what we can get it up to. 65. Well, this is exponential increase in repairing, because as our skill goes up, we get better at it. ...83%. Still only 6% improvement, but... more cleaning. Maybe clean it a little bit extra, but we'll waste 1%, but that's all right. Okay, that's all the cleaning we can do. So let's see if there's deer yet. Go for a walk, looks like. There's a wolf. If we go this way, we'll be upwind of him. We can drop bait. And hopefully the scent will come to him. Maybe we'll get a shot at a wolf. He's just prowling back and forth there. Oh, come on, give me a break. I don't need a storm now. Oh, we've got him. Man, that was intense. I wonder why he turned around. The reason we came outside was to get firewood, wasn't it? So we're full and not thirsty. If I move this bait closer, where he walked to, he came all the way up to here. So I'm going to drop this bait here. And assume he's going to come back. Might as well sketch while we're waiting. That puts us right by, what's this thing here? This looks like a tree, I guess. Right in front of us, we have a big rock. Well, I want to wait for him to come all the way back. It's going to take a while. There should be something over here. The firewood, I can get that while we're waiting. See, we've got over here. Maybe there's deer here. Sometimes there's... Oh, there's a rabbit. Oh, rabbit. Little bunny rabbit. Don't see any stones. He's got to go up the same way I do. Oh, he goes up steep stuff. Fun rabbit. I wonder where that wolf is. Maybe I can bounce him off the wall here. Rabbit chasing. Here he goes. I'm gonna aim him at the wolf. Isn't that interesting? We can get right up to him. And you steered him alright. He's hard to chase. Well, let's find a spot and go chart for a while. Chase him this way. You getting tired, Rabbit? More rabbits. Well, here's wood. I can make herbal tea right here. What's over here, Rabbit? What's over here? Huh? There's a busted tree, and there's a bear. Oh no, that's a wolf. So whereabouts are we now? By the cedar limbs, right here, straight north of the farmhouse. So away from the farmhouse is towards the mountains, which mountains all over the place. Well, there's a road here. That's the road. Let's go this way. That's towards the river, and there's a bridge over here. This is where we got lost in the storm. Somewhere over here. That's a bear. He's coming our way too. See if we can get our fatigue. Do we have any coffee on us? We do not. We're kind of wavering to kill a bear this far, and we're far from home too. Several deer. You might get mauled by the bear here. smells us too. That was enough to do it. I don't like shooting them in the back end. It's not reliable. Let's try to flank them. It's working. Oh, that's a critical hit. Try to keep him in sight here. I'm gonna chart here. It is just to wait. Gotta get our condition back and extend our map here. There's a deer carcass. Right over here. So there should be some feathers here. I think we harvested this guy up before. There's feathers. We took the guts and the meat, so all that's left is the hide. We leave that, we'll continue to get feathers here. So, where did our bear? Where did we last see our bear? Follow our tracks back here. I'm just gonna have to follow his. Oh, we've lost our tracks. And the blood trail, it looks like. Sure exactly where we are, but let's sketch it and see. Orient ourselves. So we're on the hill above the bridge there. So the bridge is off to that way, I presume, somewhere over there. And home be back that way. Well, let's take a look at our journal. See how many bears we've killed. Bears killed 4. So, moose killed 0. And we've not yet to find a get a wolf either. Wolves have been tricky on Pilgrim. There he is. Let me stay up high here. Looks like you went off that way. See if we can cut his trail. Yep, there's his trail. Where is he going to bounce now? Looks like he doubled back here. I'm not sure. Yeah, looks to me like he doubled back. As if there's two set of blood trails coming off here. We're gonna lose that blood trail in each second now. Oh, here's a blood trail. He's gonna be running straight here for a while. Until he bounces into something. Bounce into this. He's curving. I've lost the trail, darn it. It's just gone cold. We're on the trail here. Let's see if we can pick it up again. Nope, we've lost the trail. So he's still alive. Let's look at our journal. Four, so he's not dead yet. Here he is. Let's just go over there and see what happens. Could be stuck on a loop up there. Or he could be dead. That could be his dead body right there. Scaring everybody else. And he's headed back towards that broken tree, which is back towards the, where the house is. The farmhouse. Let's run out.
I need to lay down.
I know, but it's been tiring, isn't it? Deers, you go that way. You could wait for a deer to come back. There's one coming back. Quarter. We'll leave all these this meat here. We'll take the hide. Head back to the arch here. Let's take a look at our journal. If that bear, yep, we've killed the bear. So where is he?
We could just lay down and have a little sleep right here.
I've got so much stuff here. We've got that. That's heavy. A rifle. 4 kilos. Well, it's almost 10 pounds. Ooh, there's another deer. Maybe we should take a stem. What do you think? That'd be our bear, wouldn't it? We may need to take some coffee and then quarter this bear up. Fortunately, being fatigued doesn't drop our condition in Pilgrim. We could exploit that. But at this low of a condition, let's see how frozen he is. 10% frozen. Quartering costs 2 hours. 2 hours with that, 2 hours with that. And we can't. Okay. Let's go back and get the hacksaw and quarter him up. We We have some coffee, we'll drink that. That'll get us some stamina back. For late, just matches. Oh, darn it all. Okay. Well, I don't know how much firewood we have. 12 sticks. We should have a match here. Our match went out. Okay, let's do this. Get ourselves a torch.
I'm not sure I can carry much more.
Okay, well, let's drop some stuff then, buddy. Where can we drop it? Out here? Oh, this is the wrong door. I want the door over by the fridge. This door. We have some stuff to drop. Deer hide, 2 guts, some sticks. Oh, our fire is out. Drop all those sticks. Go find the hacksaw. Where did we leave the hacksaw anyways? Down here in this cabinet here, I believe. Let's look at our tools. Who's got the hacksaw? Hacksaw, where's the hacksaw? Well, maybe it's out in the... Wrong door again. In here. No, it's not. Where's the doggone hacksaw? Our torch is almost out. Just gonna have to go and harvest that bear up. Oh, where did we leave him? Where did we leave our stupid bear? course, all of our tracks have disappeared. No, they haven't. Here they are. And there's our bear. He's gonna be frozen by now. Can't be helped. We could have dropped the rifle down back there. That would have lightened our load. Let's quarter him up. Okay. Leave all this meat right here. It's gonna be dawn soon. Well, we'll be able to sleep and get back our condition. Which ports did we want? Of course, it's the ports on the other side. Well, we'll cut through the house. Some meat to cook. We do not have to cook at all tonight, but we do need to rest. So let's put our meat in here. And put a lot of this water in here as well. That leaves us with 2 liters. And let's get to bed. And get some rest and get our condition back. Our condition is still about 50%. Yeah. Could be cut off on your screen because of the way the OBS recording does. So let's turn this off. Eat and drink. Peanut butter, you are done for. Oh, we needed to cook some stuff, didn't we? Well, let's just sleep. It's not worth it right now to hassle over all that stuff. Let's just sleep. 10 hours. Ooh, we forgot to drink. Condition is all the way back to 100%. So So we didn't even need to get the herbal tea, but we had it ready. And we have a choice here of a decent t-shirt. Ooh. Drop that. Let's put away our rifle because we don't need that. We're not going to need that. We're not going to need that. Oh, we might need that. There's that hacksaw. We'll bring those two things. So we're going to need wood. We got lots of cooking to do, but fortunately we have lots of cooking spots, so that'll make it interesting. So I think we've got everything curing. That's the other one. Used to be, they're swapped, you see. This, the other door used to go out into here. And this is where we've got all of our deer hides and bear hides and guts. Cured guts. Well, what's there to do? Let's go get wood. This is getting in my way. Move that out of there. Okay. Look at all the crows today. Where's all my crow feathers, buddies? Well, I think there's also another deer up this way. Yep. There's a bunch of more crows. Just leave one bag there, that's enough. Maybe we'll get some more of these bear bags. There should be some crow feathers now. Feathers, where are you? What's with that? Why is there no feathers here?
This will come in handy.
Ooh, that's a lot. Okay. Air quarter.
This pack is getting too heavy to carry.
Yes, I know, bud. Let's get it back to the house and cook it up. Oh my, is we slow. Might have to drop one or two here. I think we're gonna get our cooking skill maxed out. I tell you what. But with all this meat, it'll be fun cooking on that big stove. If only we had more pans, eh? This is exciting. Wow, just about as exciting as shooting that bear. Well, the good news is, after we're done all this, I think all of our maple saplings will be cured. Let's see. Which door is by the kitchen door? The other side of the house, of course. I think this gets us to the kitchen quickest. Did I ever tell you the story about Bubba? Bubba and me went fishing. He drove up all the way from Alberta. He was drunk as a skunk, but he wanted to go fishing. So it was about 3 o'clock in the morning, and we started off going fishing, driving on the road to Red Lake. And I don't know if you're familiar with that road. If you, if you're on Facebook and you go into my videos, you might be able to find a video of the road to Red Lake. Anyways, it's kind of a hairpin-like road. Lots of mountains, lots of steep cliffs. And Bubba liked to drive pretty fast in his brand new 4x4 truck. Well, moral of the story is, don't drink and drive, because on the way to the lake, Bubba was, he was just getting too excited. He was just going too fast. So Bubba wasn't worried about it. He was pretty calm. But he liked to go fast. So anyways, Bubba's going around the corners and he's doing about 100 kilometers an hour. And pretty soon he's got one wheel hanging off the edge of the road. But he's not panicking any. Then he gets two wheels off in the road. Let's see, we're gonna drop this meat here because we still need to get wood. Let's drop all this. Because that was what we went out, set out to do, was to get wood. And go back out the same door. We'll just follow our footprints here. There should be more feathers here. Look how slow we go. Isn't that interesting now? The length of your pace changes with your how fatigued you are. So there should be feathers here. Really supposed to be feathers, but there's no feathers. I do not understand. Be more crows over here. Just got the one bag of meat left here. You can harvest off of it, and that won't hurt it. You'll still get crow feathers. Maybe.
What have we here?
Let's harvest it with the hacksaw. So there's very little meat left on that, but how come it suddenly got foggy here? That's not cool. That's not cool. We need wood. Let's consult our map. Zoom into the... Let's see, so we are... Where are we? That's the barn. So this is this. There's a deer carcass up there. So if we go straight away from the house, we should run into lots of cedar limbs. We'll just go this way. We can follow our tracks back if we're careful. We can leave a little trail. I don't see any tracks left here, but I am seeing wood and a deer, of all things. So that's just a branch. There's a cedar limb over here. We're gonna need a lot of wood, I'll tell you what. What's our inventory at? 30. Okay, we can take one more. Oh, man, that's annoying. We'll backtrack here. Frustrating. Lost in the fog, and it's nighttime is approaching. Okay, the fog is lifting. And that is... I wonder if we can chart back here.
Something's making me feel tired.
We got 3 rifle cleaning kits. Yeah, you're getting tired. Let's take a look at our food. I have a little snack here. Stale chocolate bar. That's enough to get us home. Okay. There's our broken tree, our guide to back home. And there's a farmhouse right below that. And over. Where is that other? Oh, yeah, the bears. Bears over here. Our footprints have disappeared. But there's the bear. The remains of the bear. I don't think we can carry him. So we got a lot of stuff to bring back. A lot of wood. Let's see if there's any feathers here at all. I don't see any feathers.
Could end up being useful.
8 kilos. Let's see if we can carry that. Close this up a bit. We've got a bunch of coffee, if I recall. But it's just as easy to bring everything in and cook it tomorrow. Where did our torch go? Don't leave her. We have tinder. Might as well use it.
did it.
It looks like we're gonna cook for about 3 hours. We'll cook this gamey venison. Thirty-six minutes. 3 hours. Deer quarter. Bear quarter. Bear quarter is at 84%. Deer quarter is at 86%. Drop our wood. Okay. And over here, how much meat? We didn't bring any quarters back, did we? Yes, we did. 84%. Fifty minutes, 46 minutes, 45 minutes. So it cooks faster on there. It's about 17 minutes. Thirty minutes, 25 minutes. So we got 25 minutes to harvest.
Something's making me feel really tired.
I know, buddy, you're tired. Seven, 46, so we got about 45 minutes of harvesting. So that takes care of that one. Okay. So that's 50 minutes, hour, 60 minutes until ready. So we got 60 minutes. Well, I'll do it. Twenty-three minutes, 38 minutes. So let's go for 40 minutes. It's 23 minutes, 19 minutes. Okay, that should do it.
I'm gonna have to leave something behind.
Look at all this delicious meat. Venison cooked. So
something's gotta go.
Yep. We gotta take a torch here. Let's put some more fire wood on the fire. And take a torch. Go over to the fridge and put our cooked meat in here. A liter of water and yeah, we got rid of all the, we need some coffee though. And work by condition, coffee. Make a bunch of, we need some tin cans for making coffee with. I think we've got some. 1 minute. Let's take that. Yeah, we got some light at least. What can we cook? Select that. We'll cook, coffee. Coffee. Herbal tea. We need water. I'm not quite ready yet. I think our torch went out. Well, we're still going here. So what did we need to cook now? More water, that's what. Let's cook 2 liters of water. Where was that? Cooking anything else, so there's no critical path here. 20 minutes. Let's cook some game venison. No, we can't cook anything with that, so we'll pick it up. And venison. So we've got 45, 42, and 11. So 11 minutes. It won't burn. 26 minutes, let's harvest that.
I'm too tired to think straight.
I know you are, bud. But you can't lose condition because you're on Pilgrim. Take that. Non-potable water. Raw. And let's do some more water. That'll be half an hour. That'll do water. That'll do half an hour. 7 minutes, 7 minutes. And we've done, gotten all of our stuff cooked. So we need a torch. go over to the fridge and put away the rest of the meat that we've cooked. We still have 3 to cook. We have a bunch of coffee to drink. And some herbal tea. Okay, we have 2 cooking pots. We can cook some meat here. Make some coffee. Three minutes, four minutes, 7 minutes. Okay. It's cooked. Water. You give us some fatigue back. Well, this is cooking. We got 2 hours left on the stove. We can get a bunch of water going.
If I don't rest soon, I'm gonna faint.
That'll be done in 26 minutes to 5 minutes. This is going to take over an hour. So it'll be melted. It'll take an hour to boil. So let's add one more stick. Okay. And that'll all be done. Until boiled, just about right. Oh, we need another torch, don't we? Well, let's get a torch. I'm sure we've got one. We'll light it off here. Let's see what we got for food now. Cooked. We got a bunch of coffee and a bunch of herbal tea. And quite a lot of water. Okay, we still have 2 liters of water. Freezer is empty. Just hang on to that. And what do we got for food? Just coffee. Coffee's good. Well, let's take some meat. And let's sort by condition. Get rid of those sardines. Let's well eat all this low condition stuff. Okay, that gets us plenty of food, and we can just go to bed and sleep the rest of the night away. And in the morning, our maple saplings should be ready and cured for making bows. So we're pretty well full. We need to drink a little bit. Oh, gamey venison is still raw. How did that happen? That was because I was in the fridge and we didn't cook it. Let's drink this. Do we have any light sources on us? No other light sources. Oh well. Let's sleep. It is now daylight. And we have a little bit of room to drink some coffee here. That'll get us boosted up a little bit, wake us up. We're still drinking it, trying to drink it. Okay. Fatigue reduced. We should go cook some more, right? I like how the shadows and everything move.
Not sure why I feel so tired.
Well, bud, because you haven't been drunk enough coffee this morning yet. That's why. We'll get you fixed up. So we're gonna need looks like we got enough cedar firewood here. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've got potable water. Oops. How come I don't have a cooking spot there? Oh, because I don't have a fire going, that's why. Let's take that charcoal. We got 9 of them. And we have some meat to cook. But we need to go get the rest of the meat before we do that. So let's drop the meat on the floor here. Eat some of that one. Drink some more coffee. Fatigue reduced. Okay. We're going to be drinking a lot of coffee today. Now, if there's no feathers here, I'm going to be ticked. Fatigued already? You're just gonna be living off coffee here. Well, that is really, really annoying.
That'll come in handy.
Okay, we'll take 4 kilos off of this. It's barely frozen. How come that is?
I need to drop something.
And yet there's no feathers here. What's with that? There should be some feathers up here.
I'd lay down right here if I thought I'd ever wake up again.
Yeah, no, we can't run anymore. Let's try to drink coffee. Coffee! We're gonna have to pee with all this coffee. Let's see what that does to us. Oh, it's got us back again. We can run.
Feels like something is sapping my energy.
We're just coming out here to look for feathers. Well, that's where the deer are, up here. Boy, look at them all. I don't know if we really need to shoot another one. It seems to me that the number of feathers is proportional to the number of guts. That would be my theory. And this one is frozen. Where haven't we charted yet? We're up here, so off to that ways we haven't charted, which would be that way. And what's our weight here? We probably got 41 kilos. Yeah. We need to go back and finish cooking. And let's see if we can drink any more coffee. Not much. Get our fatigue back. We're still quite drained. But we can get up here on top of this hill. Do a little bit of surveying. It is possible to get up there.
It's making me feel tired.
Yes, I know. Well, you're not drinking your coffee like the doctor prescribed. That's why you're getting tired. Come on, buddy. Push on, push on. You've got a job to do. You're burning daylight. I know you're tired and exhausted. But we're giving you the caffeine. Should be enough. There's a stick. Can we get up? Ooh, we cannot. Can I? Oh, look over here, we can. See that? It's just a shade less steep. And that's all we needed. We'll get up here. There's the radio tower. So there's the house over there. And that's the area that we haven't surveyed yet. So let's go over here and see if we can get a survey of these rocks. We may not be able to. These are some of our primary landmarks, these rocks. So having a good survey of them would help us. And of course, oh, look at all the firewood here. Well, we can't get it. We're just too weighted down with what are we weighted down? Oh, the rest of the bear meat. Yeah, we've got 8 kilos of bear meat and then 2 bunch of this. Can we get any more coffee down our gullets? A wee bit. Fatigue reduced, so we've got some of our fatigue back. That's not what I meant to do. I meant to do this. Chart. So that charts us right in the middle of these hills here. So let's go straight down that way and chart out in the middle of that, because that is the orchard there, and we need to chart that. So the house is that way and our orchard is that way, so let's go down here. We'll chart from the corner of this orchard up here. We'll chart there. Boy, we sure run out of jam quick. If we could just get thirsty somehow. And we could drink more coffee. Now, it used to be that there was deer in this field. And rabbits. There's a deer. By God. Just kind of keep an eye on him while we chart. There's 2 deers. What time is it? It's noon. So they come out at noon. Is that what you're saying, boss? Okay. So these trees are orchard trees, I expect. So if we head straight towards the Radio Shack, we've got another spot to map there. Alright. Well, let's head straight towards the Radio Shack then, or the Radio Tower. There's our deer. Two of them. And we need to drink more coffee. And we'll do that. Fatigue reduced. We're still pretty tired. Let's chart from the other corner here. This is kind of the last tree on this row here. Longer, so let's go down there.
My energy is just disappearing.
I know. Just disappearing because you're so tired. We made you work all night long cooking bear meat, and we still have bear meat yet to cook. Oh, this is sad to buy. But we'll use that coffee to our advantage. So let's chart here. This should complete our chart. Yeah, we're down here. And it shows rabbits there. Shows a frozen corpse over there. And more black territory there. So let's parallel the road. And survey over there. We can't run, so let's try to drink coffee. We run out of coffee. Okay. Then we eat this heavy stuff. Can't eat that. Let's drink that. We have one more coffee to cook there. Funny pattern off to the right. I guess that's the telephone line, and it's just making a strange interference pattern. Just gonna go up and look at it, see why it's like that. It's just a strange interference pattern. I think it's because we're on a low resolution. And we're getting pixelated here. So let's sketch. Okay. That fills us in right here. We didn't really get all the way down closer to the river there. So that would take us further that way. We can go there. I'm inclined to just head back because we can survey tomorrow. It's just a lovely day for surveying. That's the main thing. Coffee seems to help, but it just squeaks, you know, an hour or so out of your day, out of your fatigue. Good while you're cooking because you don't need a lot of strength, but when you're carrying stuff, you sure burn through your fatigue, through your stamina. More rabbits. More wood. This will be fur, I think. I think we'll be able to chart once we get up here. Now, limited carrying capacity sure bites you sometimes, doesn't it? Here's another fir limb. That could be cedar. Look how crooked it is. Cedar, yep. And, is that a... No, that's not the spot where the bear sometimes comes. Okay, that pretty much completes the map around the house. There's just a... So we're right up on top of this. There's cedar limbs there. So this shows us where all the firewood is, see? Fir, cedar, old man's beard's lichen, rabbit grove. So next is the map is over there. Oh, so to finish the story about Bubba. Bubba was driving on Red Lake Road and he was going crazy. And he was getting excited, a little bit excited. I mean, Bubba doesn't get excited, but sometimes he gets a little bit excited. So anyways, he's driving on the road and one wheel goes off of the edge. So what does Bubba do? You gotta keep your traction. So he pushed it a little harder on the gas pedal to maintain traction going around the hairpin curves. And then he was doing good and hanging on with three wheels, but then another wheel went off the road, so he was only hanging on with two wheels. And Bubba was beginning to get perturbed. He was starting to begin to get perturbed. I mean, Bubba's a patient guy, but this was beginning to aggravate him. So he stepped on the gas a little bit more to get more traction. Pretty soon he was hanging on with only just one wheel. One wheel was hanging on the road. And Bubba was he was beginning to get perturbed. So what did he do? He put the pedal to the metal all the way to the floor. And going around these hairpin curves, man, I mean, that, you got to respect a man with that kind of courage and that kind of bravery and that kind of... stupidity. So anyways, we start to skid off the road and we're going down the side of a mountain. Now this mountain, if you recall, the cliff goes down. I mean, it's steep. I mean, there's rocks and there's a few trees and stuff. There's a few trees here and there, but you know, mostly it's straight down. Just cliff, rocks. Well, Bubba was really starting to begin to get worked up. So he puts it to pedal to the metal and aims for the nearest tree. Smack right into the tree, crashes. Oh, the front end of the 4x4. Oh, it was such a beautiful truck, but it was totally demolished. But we did come to a halt at that point.
All this gear is slowing me down.
I know, Bubba. We're going to have to cook. Start the fire first. We got tinder. 80%, 95, 85. So best chance was with this starter here. So let's start her up. I used to have accelerant, but I think we used it all up. Somewhere around here, there's probably a light, a lantern, and some fuel, just sitting around on there. I never worry about too much about lanterns. I tend to use torches. Let's add some fuel. Okay. And we got a cooking spot, so we'll put that there. And we'll cook some gamey bear meat. Cook some gamey bear meat. Pick that up. Pick that up. Pick that up. Cook some coffee. And we'll get some more bear meat. Cook some bear meat. Here's the bear meat. There. So let's go get rid of quite so many of these things that are cluttering up our menu here. We'll put them in the fridge. All this coffee and stuff that we can't use. Herbal tea. Slap that in there. Slap that in there. Slap that in there. That's cooked. I think their stuff is ready. We're losing daylight again here. What do we? Oh, because we got reishi tea and rosehip tea. That's why. But we have no coffee. 31, 29, 40. 52, so the bear meat's still going. Let's look for coffee. Coffee. Sort by condition. Coffee should be in here. I think we run out of coffee. A to Z, coffee. Coffee cup should be right there. So we're out of coffee. So that's that. We can't cheat no more with coffee. But we can put all these things. We can put all that stuff in here. And then we won't be tempted to cook it so badly.
Drop any of this gear.
Man, you're hard to please. If we only had a bedroll. Do I have a bedroll? No. I do not have a bedroll. And I could quickly grab. I think that takes care of everything. So that's all the raw meat cooked. And There's no point in cooking up any more coffee because we haven't got any. So we need 24, 24, 58, 50. So we need 1 hour left on our stove. No, that's not what I want. How come we're... Man, it's taking a lot of torches out of here. Each torch takes about 10 minutes off our fire. 11 minutes, 45, 27. We need 43 minutes left. Okay. 6 minutes. 22, 23, 40 minutes. Okay, 17 minutes left on our fire. We'll take us a torch and toddle off to bed. We'll put some stuff in the fridge here. Take our lowest condition food, which just happens to be that. Oh, there's some coffee. How did we overlook that? And what do we got that's low condition? Herbal tea. Yeah. Let's look at our low condition meat.
Pack is getting kind of heavy.
Yeah, because what are you carrying, bud? What's so heavy? Oh, you still got firewood, bud. Okay, let's get rid of the firewood. Firewood, I said, drop. Drop, 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 drop. Cancel. Okay, that just about does it. Off to bed.
I'm so tired, I could just lay down right here.
I know you could. I think in the morning our maple saplings will be ready to... Yeah, we could eat and drink. guess it's such a low condition thing. And I want to get rid of that. I know I got lots of water, but okay, that should get us right rested. And actually, if we had, we don't have any tea with us, but that doesn't matter. I would drink tea to get our condition restored, but we'll sleep until our fatigue is all the way up. Here we go. Bonus to 21, and right now indoors it feels like 22. The actual temperature is 1 degree centigrade. And what has he got? He's well fed. He is. So saplings aren't all cured yet. That's what we're going to do. I think they're going to be cured. Birch is cured. Maple's not quite cured yet.
Okay,
so if we're going to be making, we can make snares. I'm not really interested in doing snaring here. We can make line. We can make arrow shafts. We can't make arrows because guess what? We need some arrowheads. But we may yet have arrowheads. Did we bring any arrowheads with us? Okay, so we can make arrows. We have one arrowhead. We have 30 feathers. 9 arrow shafts, but we can make one arrow, and that's all we can make. Select tool, quality tools, so we'll do that. So that helps to cut down the amount of time to make stuff. So let's see if our... like a book, but it's a picture actually. There's a whetstone, we can sharpen some stuff. So is our maple saplings cured yet? 95%. So let's go over here. Break this stuff down. Nothing hidden behind there. I thought there might be. The storm has ended. It's evening. We have a lot of cured guts. Put clothing in here. Where did that thing go? Here. And in here we'll put crafting stuff. So we've got reclaimed wood. We got cloth. And we got guts. Feathers. Material. Bandage. Why is that here? Isn't that strange? Okay. We have lots of rifle cleaning kits and lots of sewing kits and lots of sharpening. So I think we just go sleep for tonight. There's more stuff here we can break down. Thirsty. Let's have something to eat and drink. 56%. Let's eat that.
Mouth is so dry.
Yes, I know. How'd you get so thirsty? Somebody wasn't feeding you. Let's eat this MRE. Right to the red. Okay. Now we gotta get back upstairs. It's light enough I can still see. 24. What do we got that we're carrying that we don't need to? Quality tools. Drop that. We have 3 whetstones. Where did we leave the tools? Did we leave the tools? That's empty. That's food. That's clothing. And that is materials. We don't have food down here, but. Put this in here. Why is it doing that? Okay, so off we go. This is one of the favorite places I like to sleep, is out here. Fridge, freezer. So, what do we get for food? Let's grab another something here, low condition meat. 95, yeah. That'll have to do. Okay. Here's a storm lander.
This'll come in handy.
Let's light it. There's some herbal tea. How about that? Yeah, we got stuck down here. What's down under here? Anything? Sometimes there's a can opener there. What do we got in here? Just clothing, right? Yeah. Here we've got all of our tools, so let's get this out. We need to sharpen that. We need to clean that, and we need to repair that. Need to eat and drink a little bit first. So let's take some pop. It's ideal. Cure our thirst, reduce our weight. Eat that. It's risky, sardines, but I know. Too full to eat. Takes care of our thirst. And we sleep until we are fully rested. And that, I believe, should be enough for this episode. Good night, and welcome to the Long Dark Science Experiments. Please join us on Facebook and the Long Dark community. Good night.